Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Chelsea and I am a full-time reseller. I sell on Poshmark, eBay, and Mercari. I like to do haul videos, mostly from the Goodwill outlet. I do some tips and tricks videos, some of my strategies. Lots of different videos. So if you're interested in anything reseller related content, feel free to hit that subscribe button. So you'll be notified next time I post a video. Hit the little bell icon as well. And if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. It really does help me and my channel so my video can reach more people. I am excited that my channel is growing. Thank you for everyone who has subscribed already. I really, really appreciate it. And I appreciate you watching. It's fun to talk with all of you guys down in the comment section. I've learned so much from all of you. I'm telling you, I feel like I've learned more than what I've shared. So it's been really great getting to know all of you. So thank you for commenting. Anyway, let's get into the haul. So I went to the Goodwill outlet today. I cannot remember exactly how much I spent. I know it was around 50 something dollars. So I'll put that here along with the amount of weight that I bought, the pounds that I bought. So anyway, I'm going to do a haul for you and show you what I picked up. I did pick up some things for Plato's Closet as well, but I've already removed those items because I took them to Plato's Closet earlier today. They did buy some things already from this haul. I made $31 today already. So I spent $50. I already made back $31 and I still have tons of stuff to list. So I'm already halfway there to making a profit. Actually, more than halfway there to making a profit. So let's get into the haul and I'll show you what I got to sell. So the first thing I got is this Meadow Rue blouse. It's got this really pretty lace scallop detailing on it. It's long sleeved, super cute. It's a size small, and Meadow Rue, this is an Anthropologie top. I got this wonderful vintage number. So she has a lace collar, which is just so cute. the brand is Lucy Fellini. LA, Milan, New York. It's a size 14 average. That's what it says, 14 average. But anyway, it's this really pretty floral print dress with this pleating. It's, you know, like a nice polyester nylon blend, you know, and 3/4 length sleeves with some wonderful shoulder pads. So I'll be sure to get that listed soon. All right, next is this vintage skirt by Norton McNaughton. I liked this because it's just that nice pleated stretchy waist skirt that you could just style so cute nowadays with a more modern style shirt. And that's a size 14. I got this super fun apron. Totally retro vibes. 70s maybe. It's this apron that you kind of, you pull on like this. Like that, and it buttons in the back. So super cute. And it has a button in the back right here to enclose it, and it also ties as well. So that's fun. My grandma had one like that. I think my aunt had one as well. So it made me think of them. All right, I got some vintage Gymboree, little kids stuff. I found that vintage kids clothes sells well on eBay. Specifically Oshkosh B'gosh, if you were not aware of that. If you come across any in the thrift stores, look it up because there are some really good bolos. I have an auction going right now and it's this one little Oshkosh B'gosh dress and it's already at like it's at $87 right now. So yeah, look out for that kind of stuff. I don't know that this is worth much. I just thought it was so cute, and if it's not, you know, I saved a cute piece of clothing from the landfill. And then this is another Gymboree outfit, which is just so cute. And then the sleeve was rolled up like this. And then inside the sleeve are the cutest little matching socks I've ever seen. And they match the little outfit. So I'm going to roll those back up in there so I don't lose them. But yeah, it's just so precious. And look at this collar. So anyway, those are Gymboree. And I think they're both, they say newborn or infant on them. All right, I got another slip. You know, me and my vintage slips, got to pick them all up. This is from Sears. It looks like a size small, just a small little slip. All right, I got some Nuit Tag stuff that I'll probably send into ThredUp. I don't know if these are both Nuit Tags or just one. Okay, this one's new with tags. It's just new with tags chaps. And it's like this boho Aztec style vest. I'm going to send that into ThredUp. And then this is also chaps. This is, I guess, not new with tags, but it's just a really cute zip front, almost like a zipped on the side sweater. And I just picked it up based on style. Whole nother bag here. But before we move into that bag, let me show you my shoe finds. Can you tell what that is? I got some Allbirds. So these are not in perfect condition. I just picked them up because the brand will sell them, but I won't be able to list them for very much because they are missing the insoles. The size, they're size 11. The Tree Runners, I think is what they're called. And then there's like a tiny little hole right here in this shoe, but I just couldn't pass them up. I know they'll sell for something. If I have to send them off to eBay auction, I'll know, I'll probably get like 15, 20 bucks on them. I don't know. Maybe I'm being under ambitious. We'll see. All right. I got this to take to Once Upon a Child, this cute little astronaut jacket. I got this to sell myself. Just another little nightie. The brand is just Secret Treasures. I don't know that this one's vintage, but has like that floral, almost animal print look to it. Really cute. This is Pure and Good. I think this is sold by Anthropologie. It's a size medium. I don't know if it's Anthropologie or Urban, but just a cute little crop. So got this shirt. It's Cotton Impressions, but it's got this skeleton in it on it, and it's kind of stained, but it's vintage and it has like Greek lettering, and there's the back of the skeleton, and then the logo says 1997 Cotton Expressions Limited, and then over here it says, I said like the name of a museum or something, I remember seeing for, yeah, the Field Museum in Chicago, Illinois. So I need to do a little more research on this, and I'll let you know what it's worth. I'll probably put that over here, what I ended up listing it for, and I'll probably try to get some stains out, but if they don't come out, it is vintage. And people normally don't mind stains as much when something's vintage. So we'll see. I got this cute, it's pure gold, made in USA skirt, but it's like this knit skirt that I just thought was really cute. I've been seeing on Instagram and social media, people will buy these type of skirts and then they'll wear like a knit sweater with it. So it's like a set of knitwear. So I don't know if that's gonna be another trend again this fall. So I grabbed it just in case. Some lace doily thing. I don't know what this is used for. Do you wear it? It's probably some type of decoration, but my lace doilies that I've been picking up are consistently selling for me. So I will keep picking them up if people keep buying them. All right, I did find a Victoria's Secret robe. It's a small or extra small, and I love it when the strap is tied onto it because I cannot tell you how many robes I find at the bins that I don't end up buying because the robe is not attached. So I was happy to get this one. It's really soft. I wonder what the fabric content is. So I don't see a tag that has the fabric content, but it is very soft. It feels silky. All right, the next item I got is these 501 Levi's. They are cutoffs and they are button fly. So I found them at the bins just like this. I'll probably wash them again and hopefully this fraying will fray a little bit more. And then, you know, if not, I'll just roll them and photograph it with a rolled hem, but also show that it's not super frayed. But it will fray with time and it'll be really nice and trendy once that starts fraying. I got some Fit Flops. These need to be cleaned a little bit, but Fit Flops do well for me. I've never picked up this style before, but they look to be going for around $20. So hopefully we'll see if I end up getting that much. Woo! I picked these up for ThredUp as well. They are the Sophie Classic Trouser Pant. They're Liz Claiborne Career. They're retail for $49. And yeah, just some relaxed fit work pants. Okay, next I found some American Eagle jeggings. Yeah, they're just the American Eagle jeggings, that's all it says. And they're a size 6 regular, in pretty good condition. I don't really see any pulling or puckering, so yeah. So are definitely a closet staple. These are wild, but I liked them. So they're Free People leggings, and they're like these stripe leggings, all of these buttons at the bottom. So those are fun. I found a Bowden top. It's like a tunic top. It's pink and purple and white. So yeah, good find. I love selling Bowden. It usually sells pretty quick for me. Oh, here's the belt that matches that lovely vintage dress I showed you earlier. All right, still got a lot to show you here. This is a really cool vintage top. It's one of those, what do you call these? The ones that have the, where it tucks in? I forgot what they're called. But yeah, just a cute little blouse and it's vintage. Let me see if I can find the tag to show you. Lucianne 2, size large. So there is the tag. I got a little Gymboree dress. That's 5T. Probably take that into Once Upon a Child. Got a Simply Southern top. Says, my heart belongs to a Southern boy. Aw, isn't that cute? This is a size medium. And it looks to be in really good condition. So I'm happy about that. This is really fun. I think this is 100% silk. Yes. The brand is Spiegel. And it's 100% silk top. And it has these wonderful cats on it. So cheetahs, leopards. Is that a jaguar? I'm not really sure. But I just am loving the cat print. I just think it's wonderful. Yeah, that's fun. Couldn't pass it up. I got another nightgown. Surprise, surprise. This is the Fashion Place by Sears Roebuck. It says contemporary lingerie. But anyway, it has like this really cute collar and it's a maxi length with this cute little detailing right there. So yeah, there's a few little snags in it, but overall in very good condition. I don't know if there's a size tag anywhere, but really cute. I found some 1 teaspoon jeans. These are pretty rough. They're the awesome baggies. Yeah, they're pretty destroyed, but I was looking online and some of the ones they were selling were not too much more destroyed than these ones, or these ones were not too much more destroyed than other ones they were selling. So yeah, these probably will not go for very much, but I got them just based on the brand. Someone could cut these into some shorts if they wanted to, just have some slightly less distressed shorts. But I figured I'd give them a shot just because I don't know why. Hopefully they sell. All right, I found some Lululemon and it has the pull tag on it. So it's got like this almost camo look to it. And it has a, like a T-strap back. And here's your little logo. And I don't know what the size is. It's a size 12. But yeah, to find one with this pull tag still on it was pretty darn exciting. All right, next is this Vanity Fair piece of lingerie robe thing. It's button front all the way down the front. It's got a collar and then this pretty detailing there and this just beautiful bright red color. It does have some little snags in the back, but it's in pretty good condition overall. All right, next is a pair of Carhartt jeans. These are the loose straight style. They're a size 40, 32. Just a pair of men's jeans in really good condition. I don't pick up a lot of men's items, but I do know Carhartt is a brand that my husband likes to buy, and I know what he pays for it when he buys a new, so I just couldn't pass up on those. And the comps look to be around $20 to $30 for reselling those, so I was happy with that. This robe is so pretty. So it's another vintage robe. The brand is Lorian, and it's a size medium, made in the USA. It's got a tie back with some pretty ruching going on there, some lace detailing on the sleeves, and it has this really pretty detailing here. It does have a hole in the armpit, but it was just too good to pass up on, so I decided to break down and I will sew that up and repair it just because I just love me some good vintage nightgowns. So I will fix that and list it. This was a really exciting find. I was digging through a bin next to someone else who was sorting through her cart and she threw these back. And let me tell you, I snatched them. Do you see what that is? Free People. So these are a size large and there are some really good jeans. So they're like button fly and they have like almost like a paper bag cinched waist and wide leg. And then looks like the cuff gets rolled, which would be super cute. But yeah, I just really love these jeans. I wish they were my size. They are so cute. I don't even know if you call them jeans. They're a very soft, like, fabric. So yeah, love those. If anyone's a size large and needs some good for people jeans, hit me up. All right, I got some 7 jeans. These are a size 6. They are the high rise skinny and they're in really good condition for a pair of jeans from the bins. It's hard for me to find perfect condition jeans at the bins. So when I do find a pair, especially in plus size, I grab them. I got this dress and I just love the embroidery. The brand is Katie, which I had never heard of before, but when I looked up comps, it looks like it's selling for $25 to $30, which is my sweet spot when it comes to dresses. So I snatched this up and I just love it. It's a size small, but it's a very oversized small. So I'll have to model that one and see how it looks. All right, I got some Oshkosh B'gosh Genuine overalls. They're this really cute corduroy style and they open up here. So hopefully these will be worth a pretty penny. I'm not expecting them to, but if they are, that would be exciting. So looks like eBay is the place to sell Oshkosh. It's just got a following over there. So I'll probably throw those up over there and we'll see if I end up even listing them on Poshmark. All right, I got this. It says, Make America Happy Again, Simply Southern. That's a really cute little logo there. Wonder if it's the same size as that other one. If so, I could bundle them. I should not try this on. It's a Maeve top, and it's got this like really pretty embroidered lace cutout detailing. Flutter sleeves. So cute. And it's a size small by Maeve, and that's an Anthropologie brand. So cute. And it's button front. I love it. All right, next I got this Land's End swimsuit top. These always sell well for me. When I pick up Land's End swimsuits, they usually move pretty quick. And this is just the top, which actually I prefer to pick up just tops. I don't really enjoy selling bottoms from the bins because it can be a little sketchy, but this is just so cute and figure flattering. And I bet you this will sell before summer hits. Those people who are going on cruises for the winter, I'm telling you, I sell swimsuits in the winter. So this is a size 12 Land's End. Another piece of vintage lace doily crochet thing. All right. This was just too cute to pass up on. It says dash hound through the snow. It's new with tags from, I don't know. This looks like a JCPenney tag, maybe? But it's a size medium, just a really cute little dachshund top. I'll probably list that myself. I just am a sucker for the cute Christmas stuff, and my mom had a dachshund growing up. My brother has dachshunds, so I just had to get it. This is a LuLaRoe dress, and I don't normally pick up LuLaRoe, but something about this print just spoke to me, and it is a maxi dress, and it's in, like, perfect condition, so hopefully I make some money on this and I don't regret it. I'll probably take these to Once Upon a Child. They're just Levi's cargo shorts from Marshalls. They were originally $12.99. Super cute. I got a J. McLaughlin top. It's like this almost equestrian style top. It's a stretchy top, size large. I may send this into ThredUp, but if I decide not to, I'll list it myself. Last but not least is a LuLaRoe duster cardigan that I actually think is really, really pretty. I picked this up based on style because I just love it. It's like this velvet. It's a Sarah cardigan and it's a size medium and it's just such a pretty velvet. I don't know. I really like it and it has pockets. So yeah, this is actually a piece of LuLaRoe that I think will sell and sell for a decent amount because of the style. So that is my Goodwill Outlet haul. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know if you have any comments or questions down in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a great day and be sure to hit that like button if you liked this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Have a great day. Bye.